having next class. Next class is on diagnosis. So briefly, we'll go on diagnosis today, and we'll carry on with the next class. Diagnosis, you all know, you have already dealt with it. Your oral medicine, your general surgery, all your clinical course you've already dealt. Diagnosis in oral surgery is slightly different than other departments, where we have to ascertain the medical condition because we are doing an invasive procedure. The other departments, oral medicine and other departments, it is mainly as investigative procedure. When you come to oral surgery, the procedures we will take that to reach a diagnosis, and when you do an invasive procedure, we have to make sure proper history and proper diagnosis should be done before doing the procedure. When you come to the diagnosis, always a diagnosis will start with the history. First, we'll start with the chief complaint of the patient. We ask the patient, what is the problem? So, patient will tell. The chief complaint, you have to record the patient's own words. Don't use any medical terms. The patient says, useless of the tooth, right to this, never write mobility. Mobility is the medical. So, write it as the patient's own words. After that, when you come to the history of presenting illness, you have to elaborate on your chief complaint. So, when the patient says pain, so first thing you will ask is how long? Simply, how long you are having pain? Then, what do you do when pain increases? Is it due to when you take food, when you rest, when you sleep in the night? When is the pain more? The duration of pain. And do you do anything to reduce the pain? Any tablets? That way you take history and what is the nature of pain, whether it is sharp pain, dull pain. So based on all this, we'll give you a clue whether it is an acute pain, chronic pain, pulmonary pain or whatever it is. So from there itself, your diagnosis will start from your history. So your chief complaint and history of presenting illness, in that you have to take detailed history, whether patient had any medication or any treatment for that. So that will all give you a clue what is the problem or whatever. Then next is you have to take a medical history. That is where it's very important. Medical history, when you ask, you have to ask in detail whether patient. You can ask direct questions or indirect questions. Direct question is you would ask the patient whether the patient's got diabetes, hypertension, all that. That is all direct questions. But sometimes patient may not give you proper. So there are some indirect questions which are going to give you a proper history. What are those indirect questions? What indirect questions you can ask a patient to get a proper history? Anything? Family history is next. You can ask whether the patient is on long-term medication, isn't it? You ask the patient, are you taking any medicines for a long time? That is going to give you a clue. Sometimes you will miss out. Patient may be taking a long-term steroid. That is one thing you may miss out. So if you ask, for the past 1 year, you have been taking any medicines regularly for some disease, or any history of hospitalization, whether patient was hospitalized due to any reason. And that way you take history, you ask history, medical history, keep on asking. From there you will be able to know the medical condition of the patient. That is very important. Of course, that is going to influence you for your treatment modality, or either you are going to modify your treatment modality, or you think you need a decision function for the doctor. Right? Then next is, after you take a medical history, you go for family history. Family history is, of course, there are a lot of diseases which are hereditary. Hypertension, psychiatric disorders, all that. So you have to ask family history. After family history, you go for personal history, diet, depression, and all that. So with all this history, you will get a base, what problem patient may be having. Then after getting all this only, to go for a general examination. General examination of the patient will start with, you have to start with, start with, very good. Age means you have to start observing the patient as he walks to the clinic. That is how a clinician will do. You will not see the patient after he sits in the chair. As he walks into the clinic, you will observe how he is walking and coming, whether the gait is normal, any problem with the gait and how the build is, nourishment, all that you will check. Then specifically you will look for pallor, sinus, then vitreous, all right, general examination. So you start, your examination will start as a wish box in the beginning. Start with the gate, then with the, how the build is, all this is there. You come to the examination of your cyanosis, anemia, interest, clubbing, all this should be checked. After that, you go for your vitals. Your vitals you have to check for BP, pulse, respiration, all this should be checked. So after doing all this, will give you again a more concrete diagnosis. First, it just give you a base, then you will form a better diagnosis by the end. After that, we will go for a local examination. So, don't touch the patient till you have finished your history, your general examination, your examination of all the system. Then, you will go for your local examination. Local examination will start with not with the mouth, it will start with the face. Face, it will start with the symmetry, whether the face is symmetrical, then you look for all the area. Yeah, actually, you are supposed to start with the forehead, eyes, nose, cheek, then you come to the lower bottom, mandible, lips, all this should be actually examined before you put your mirror into the mouth. Because everybody is in a hurry to put their mirror into the mouth and examine and find the diagnosis. So, diagnosis, to come to the diagnosis, you need to spend more time with the patient to get a proper diagnosis. So you have to do in a systemic manner all this. After that way you do a local examination. You see what the patient's problem is and don't look at only at the teeth. Again you are going to examine all the areas of the body. You have to examine the palate, lower the mouth. Because you are the ones who may be the first one to see a lesion or a malignancy in the lower of the mouth. This patient may not know there is a lesion. When you examine, we are the ones who will be the first ones to detect any ulcer or anything inside the orbital. Make sure not only the teeth, you examine all the areas, you examine the tongue, lower of the mouth, palate, everything should be examined. Then you examine whatever the patient has to do, tooth or whatever, you examine. When you examine, again don't examine only the tooth, see the neighboring tooth, upper tooth. So sometimes patient will tell you pain. When you see the tooth, no pain. We had one patient coming telling we have pain, then we look, there is nothing wrong with the teeth. Then, when we purpose, pain is there in the upper tooth. It is basically because of sinusitis. Patient had cold and this thing. Pain was referred. So, earlier I have read in my book also, a lot of extractions were done in the upper tooth because of maximum sinusitis. Because it was misdiagnosed. Because of pain, they will go away extraction. So, in such conditions also, please, you have to check all the tooth, every tooth, everything, upper tooth, everything you check. And systematically you examine the tooth, everything. Again, it will end up with examining your TMJ lymph nodes. Lymph nodes should be examined. All your group of lymph nodes you have, your level 1, 2, 3, 4, all the levels should be checked. And finally, you come to a provisional diagnosis, not a total. Again, you are coming to a provisional diagnosis, where you have two or three provisional diagnoses. You will not have a single diagnosis. From there, again, after provisional diagnosis, you come to a certain diagnosis after doing your investigation. If needed, you take a IOP or OPG or whatever, you find out and then come to a final diagnosis. This is how you go about examining a patient. So these are the steps. We have history, clinical examination, radiology, lab investigation and final diagnosis. So we have touched with the history, we have told you history is, you have to start with the patient's chief complaint, then we have to see the history of presenting illness, we have to check for the date of onset, the duration, the location, the aggravating factors, any treatment received. All this should be asked in your history of presenting illness. Your past medical history, all this should be asked in the patient, whether the patient has any symptoms, fever, weight loss. How do you have weight loss? Which condition you have weight loss? Tuberculosis. Very good. One more condition. Weight loss more than 10% in a month is condition for HIV. You have criteria. So you have to ask all that history of medication. That is what is going to help you. Then hospitalization, operation, allergy, bleeding tendency, cardiovascular. All this should be asked in your medical history. Past dental, any relevant dental history. What are the things you ask in your dental history? Any relevant needs? Undergone extraction patients. No. Any problem during the extraction? The patient has undergone extraction 6 months back. What are the things you could ask? Whether patient had any bleeding during the procedure? Patient had any syncope? Allergy, you are using drugs, so this will help you. So if the patient says I have allergy during the injection, you modify. Understood? Any bleeding, okay? You check whether the patient has got any bleeding problems. So these are the things you have to ask in your past dental history. Personal history, smoking, all that, this is going to influence your treatment. Or another way is you can counsel the patient. You see, if the patient is smoking, you can. So they know all this, it is there, it is seen. But still, when a doctor tells them, they may, twice. So you can counsel the patient also. Family history, any diseases, hereditary diseases like psychiatric conditions, BP, diabetes, all that. Now coming to clinical examination, we told you have to check whether this temperature, pulse, BP, respiratory rate, these all should be checked in the clinical examination. So before you go to the local examination, you make sure you check the vitals of the patient. Now coming to the extraoral examination, I told you have to start with the face, lymph node, eyes, and on palpation you check for the TMJ, any history of trauma, swelling, all this should be checked. You may miss out small things in case